Hello, dear friends, how are you? So next week, Wednesday evening, May 18th, we're going to celebrate this unique holiday called Lag BaOmer. It's also Thursday the 19th, means it's 24 hours starting on May 18th in the evening, and then Thursday, May the 19th, the entire day. What's Lag BaOmer is all about? Lag BaOmer, it's the 33rd day for the counting of the Omer. Maybe you heard about the counting of the Omer, maybe you didn't. But between Passover and the following holiday called Shavuot, there are exactly 49 days. And every day from the next day after Passover, we're counting. We say, today is one day to the Omer. Today is the second day to the Omer, etc., etc. Why? What's so unique about it? Why we need to count another day and another day? Counting, also in Hebrew, it means to limit. When you count something, you're basically limiting it. The idea is that during this time, this period of time between Pesach, Passover, and Shavuot, it's a unique opportunity that the Creator gives us, opportunity to increase our vessel, means increase the level of our desire. That's why we're growing. We're growing in our desire, because on the day of Shavuot, it's the totality of the light. On the day of Shavuot, all the blessing, all the light of God is entering. Passover is just the beginning of going out of exile, going out of Egypt. And as we enter, means as we left Egypt, we're starting to grow in our consciousness. When we left Egypt, we were just going out of the darkness, of the negative consciousness. Now we want to actually start to build our real desire for the light force of the Creator. That's what's happening between Pesach and Shavuot. But in order to build a real desire for the light force of the Creator, you need to limit and to control the desire to receive for the self alone. It's like a wild beast, like a wild horse, or a wild bull, right? That is like getting crazy. We have the beast inside us. We have the desire to receive for the self alone. Unfortunately, Rabbi Ashlag explains, usually we're not aware how much the desire to receive for the self alone within us is like a beast, is like a wild animal, that it's dangerous if we're not controlling it. We're not aware. We don't really realize how, like, the effect and where it can take us. Where it can take us if we're not controlling it. So what's happening, the gift that God gives us between Pesach and Shavuot is, from one hand, to increase our desire. Why to increase our desire? Because the whole point of God is that we will enjoy from His endless light. Right? So if a person just wants just a little bit here and there from life, that's all what I want, you know. So God says, but I want to give you everything. I want to give you endless. So God says, no. You have to increase your desire. You have to build a real desire for the light. A desire that wants the light force of God without end. That's what we're gaining between Pesach and Shavuot. The ability to grow our desire. To increase our desire. But from the other hand, as you're growing your desire, you also need to control it. And to tune it and to focus it, that the desire that it will be in the right focus, in the right consciousness, that the desire to receive will be tuned, that it will be for the sake of sharing. That's what we're doing during the counting of the Omer every day. It's kind of a struggle. We feel during the time of the Omer, we feel that there is a struggle within us. And the work that we should do, And also as we counting the omer, we meditating, that I'm actually increasing my desire for the rightfulness of God, but I'm meditating that the reason why I want more is only so I can reveal more light, only that I can share more. And that's the work that we're doing during the 49 days, which is exactly 7 weeks. 7 times 7 is 49. And Lag BaOmer, this unique holiday, it's the 33rd day for the counting of the Omer. So from the time of creation already, this day was a unique day, that on that day, we have the ability to stop and to control the desire to receive for the self alone in a very powerful way. It says about Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva, he basically, he lived around 2,000 years ago, in the time that the Roman Empire was controlling the Middle East and also the territory of Israel, and they also destroyed and burned the Holy Temple, unfortunately. And Rabbi Akiva had 24,000 students, and they were learning in couples. Every two students were learning together, and they were spread all around Israel. They were teaching the message of Rabbi Akiva, the message of Kabbalah, the message of the Torah, to people all around Israel. And it says that they all, 24,000 students, they all died between Passover and Lag BaOmer, the 33rd day of the Omer. And it says in the ancient writings, it says the reason why they died is because they didn't give enough respect and care for one another, means for each other. And that's the reason. That's the reason. And during this time of the Omer, we want to remember and feel the pain of unbelievable spiritual giant, righteous people that actually died, all died in a plague in such a short period of time, just because they didn't enough put attention in the idea of respect and care for each other. But what's the deeper message? Means, you know, what we can learn here. And by the way, there were 5 students of Rabbi Akiva. They actually didn't die. One of them was Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. One of them, one of the 5. And Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, you know, who are the one that didn't die? The one that didn't die are the ones that actually realized and understood the deeper message of what their teacher, Rabbi Akiva, wanted to teach them. You know, in the most important book of Rabbi Ashlag, means gift of the Bible or giving of the Bible, giving of the Torah, that if you pay attention, I actually teach many times from this book, and I actually sending you lessons teaching from this book, which is incredible book and articles that actually really life-changing. And you know, the beginning of that book, Rabbi Ashlag is quoting Rabbi Akiva, the teacher of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, and he's quoting Rabbi Akiva, that Rabbi Akiva says that the entire message of God, the entire message of the Torah, is included in the one sentence, which is love the fellow man as thyself. That's the entire message of God. And that was what Rabbi Akiva tried to teach his students. And they understood this lesson, but probably they didn't understand it as Rabbi Akiva wanted to teach it to them. They missed the deeper meaning. Somehow they were spiritual people and everything, and eventually they didn't put all their effort, they didn't put all their focus on that, sentence, on that message, that that's the only thing that really matter. And we know that the, you know, the evil inclination would actually allow you to do a lot of spiritual things in life, but the one thing that he would not allow you is to actually really focus on that one idea, really care for the other human being. And it's not just real care for one or few human beings, it's actually real care, real love for all humanity. What does it mean, real love and care for all humanity? It means that I realize that there's actual pain in the world. People go through pain. What did I do? What am I doing so I can change the world for a better place, so I can improve the world, so I can help the world to be corrected, so I can help people to stop with the pain in their life? That means to love people. It means to care for them. It means to go out of our comfort zone in order to stop the chaos in the world, stop the pain in the world, and help people to remove pain from their life and help people to get closer and closer connected to the true reality, to the real reality, to the reality of the lightfulness of God. Soon I would like to read something from the Zohar, but I would like us to realize that what we're doing now, and you know, again, when the students of Rabbi Akiva stopped dying on Lag BaOmer, and Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai, the student that actually didn't die in the plague, that's the day that he was born, and that's the day that he also left the world. The 18th day of the lunar month of Iyar, which is Taurus. And the lesson for us, the message for us, that the focus that we would like to focus in the gift of the death anniversary of Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai, what we call Lag BaOmer, is the gift of having the ability to stop the darkness, to stop what we call Tree of Knowledge, Good and Bad, or the Matrix. Remember the movie The Matrix? If you never saw it, I really would recommend to, you know, to see it. Probably there is a way to see it online. You can check it out. And this movie actually, you know, help us to realize how a person can live a regular life like you, like all of us, but actually his mind is completely controlled by the negative forces. And a person, actually the entire reality that he lives is false reality. It's not the real reality. It's not the true reality. And a person needs to do tremendous work in order to escape the false reality, in order to escape the illusionary reality, not the real reality, not the reality of what we call in Kabbalah the tree of life reality, which is the reality of the life force of the Creator. And in order to escape from the tree of knowledge, good and bad, from the world of the Matrix, to actually gain access to the world of the Creator, to the reality of God, what we call the Tree of Life reality, which everything is truthful over there, person need to do a tremendous spiritual inner change in order to gain it. And, you know, the beauty is that Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai was one of the souls actually had the ability to escape from the Matrix, to escape from the Tree of Knowledge, Good and Bad. You know, there is like those kind of, you know, I'm not sure how do you call it in America, in Israel, they call it escape rooms. It's like a special room that you need to find different kind of clues and codes, and each code, each clue lead you to the next clue. Eventually you need to find the treasure or whatever. This, it's like a game that few people enter in a room. It's like called escape room. Maybe you also call it like that in America. But you know, that's kind of fun, you know, it's like a game. And in life, we like those kind of games that they need to do like different things in order to escape and to find the clues how to escape from a certain room. We also like, you know, some people like action movies from Hollywood, that it's like, you know, the good guys against the bad guys, and like, but this is all just in the movies, right? This is just external excitement that gives, wow, amazing how the good guys won and they destroyed the bad guys, right? But then we go to regular life and we bored again. We say, maybe I need to go to another experience with the escape room. Maybe I need to see another action movie, because we don't realize that we live in an action movie, in the most exciting and the most kind of fascinating and the most difficult, you know, action movie, the most kind of difficult escape room. It's life itself. You don't need to go and to do it externally. Just live your life properly, and every second you are in the most amazing action movie that you have to escape from the Matrix. You have to escape from the tree of knowledge, good and bad. Otherwise, you actually live in a whole illusion. And the work is to find the code how to escape from the Matrix, how to escape from the illusionary world that exists in your mind, that it's actually false. This is such such a mission, such a kind of difficult thing to do and challenging thing to do. But if you know how to do it, if you have the ability to teach yourself how to do it and actually make it happen, it's the most exciting thing. It's the most, you know, fascinating thing. It's the most fulfilling thing, because you could do it by yourself. You escape the Matrix because of your own effort, your own desire, your own, you know, hard work. And again, what does it mean exactly to escape the Matrix in our everyday? The idea is that we, you know, we all need to realize, again, the students of Rabbi Akiva, they understood spirituality, but they still didn't do enough work to escape from the Matrix. And they didn't realize that in order to escape the tree of life, good and bad, tree of knowledge, good and bad, you have to work so hard and put all your effort and all your heart and all your energy toward caring for others with all your heart, not just when I have time or if I feel like, if I'll have the ability. It's like your focus, you do it for yourself, you do it because you want to escape the Matrix. Because of that, they actually fell to the darkness, and you know, the darkness took over them. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai had the ability, had the courage, had the strength to escape the Matrix. He got to that kind of level that he could break through the code of the tree of knowledge, good and bad, because he understood truly and deeply what his teacher, Rabbi Akiva, is trying to teach him. It's interesting that Rabbi Akiva and Rabbi Ashlag, they both left the world in the same day, which is Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement. And Rabbi Akiva talks about love the neighbors as the self as the most important focus of life. And also, if you follow the teachings of Rabbi Ashlag properly, you'll see that he constantly teaching the same thing. It's like it's kind of the same message. And if the students of Rabbi Akiva didn't listen properly to their teacher, and then they thought or they told themselves, we already understand what Rabbi Akiva taught us, it's okay, he's repeating again and again, love the neighbors, they feel, okay, it's kind of, you know, we got the idea. And if we don't listen properly and closely to the message of Rabbi Ashlag that is telling us again and again and again the same idea. Focus your energy on caring for others. And that's how you're escaping the matrix. Rabbi Ashlag telling it to us again and again. And he says that because people don't learn it properly, don't learn Kabbalah properly, and they don't put the focus properly, the chaos continue to remain in their life and in the world. And that's why, you know, on the day of Lag BaOmer, that it's just next week, and we'd like to prepare ourselves. On the day of Lag BaOmer, we want to connect to the message of Rabbi Shimon Bar Chai, to the light that Rabbi Shimon Bar Chai revealed in the world. And we want to gain that ability that we also gonna escape from the matrix. That's what we can gain on that unique day. That's the day that the plague stopped. That's the day that we can say stop to the tree of knowledge, good and bad. Stop to the evil inclination within us in the world. We should say it, and we should escape the matrix on that day. How do we do it? By listening closely and carefully to the message of our teacher. Our teacher is Rabbi Ashlag. And Rabbi Ashlag, in order to really get his teaching, we need to open his books and read again and again, and especially the most important book of Rabbi Ashlag, as I mentioned before, The Gift of the Bible. And to read carefully and closely what he's saying over there, and try to internalize and to realize what is the message for me in this world. And then we can actually change a cassette from the tree of knowledge, good and bad, and to actually start to be connected truly and properly to the tree of life. I also want to read a message from the Zohar. I read it already a few times in the past, but it's always good to read it again, especially just 1 week before the anniversary of Rabbi Shimon Bar Chai, which is called Lag BaOmer. By the way, next week on Wednesday night, I probably, hopefully, I'll do some kind of live connection so you can join and connect. And also I hope that I'll have the ability to send like a booklet that you can read that booklet online during the entire day of Lag BaOmer. It's special kind of sections from the Zohar to connect. It's a great day. It's a day of joy. It's a day of happiness. It's a day to have for ourselves a meal, a nice meal that makes us happy. It's a day to do a lot of good things for others. You know, the booklet that I'll send you online, I recommend for you, you can also share it with others on that day of Rabbi Shimon, so more and more people would actually read at least one paragraph from the Zohar, because as we know already, when you're reading a paragraph from the Zohar, it helps you to create spiritual cleansing. Just by scanning or reading the Aramaic letters, there's light that shine through the letters and clean our consciousness, clean our mind, clean our heart, clean our entire being from what I just explained and described before, from the matrix. What is the matrix? The matrix again is like this kind of illusionary reality that try to control our mind, try to control our consciousness, and makes us think or feel the things that actually good for us. The matrix forcing us to believe and to think and to feel that the things that are good for us are actually bad for us. And the matrix also make us think and feel that the things that are bad for us are actually good for us. This reality is completely false, completely upside down. It's unbelievable because, you know, you meet people that are smart, intelligent, they understand many things. They realize that the way that they see life, the way that they understand the reality is completely upside down. Again, you don't judge them, but it's like to realize how much the matrix can be strong and how much you need to desire to escape the matrix and to do anything in your power to run away from the matrix. Otherwise, it will take over you and control you, and you'd not even be able to realize that you're under the control of the matrix. And it says, actually, and that's why on the day of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, the biggest gift, it's not just, wow, that's a nice day, the day of Rabbi Shimon, the day of the Zohar, the day that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai left the world, that's also the day that he was born, that's also the day that he finished writing the Zohar. It's a day, it's such a day full of light. But more than anything, it's a day that we would like to escape from the matrix. It's a day that we would like to help other people as much as we can. Because if you really care for people, caring for someone, it's not just to offer them a cup of water if they thirsty. Caring for someone in a deep way is to care for the other human being. To realize, wow, this person is under the control of the matrix. Because I love him so much. I love him or her. I love them so much. I would give them a hand and I'll help them say, hey, my friend, take my hand. I'll help you to go out of the matrix because I care for you so much. I'll help you. Please hold me. I'm helping you to go out. Right? How do you help another human being to go out of the matrix? By teaching them Kabbalah. That's what the Zohar says. That the teachings of Kabbalah, that the knowledge, the consciousness of Kabbalah is the consciousness that helps a person to escape the matrix. And to, oh my God, I didn't realize how blind I was. That's how people need to wake up. How much I was under the illusion, under the effect of the negative side, of the matrix. And as a person learns Kabbalah more and more in the right consciousness from Rabbi Ashler, and from the Zohar, more person clean his consciousness and clean his entire being from the matrix and starting to be truly connected to the real reality, to the reality of God, which is the reality of the Tree of Life, which is the reality of true care and true love. And and that's what we want to focus on the day of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai and also help as many people possible. That's why we're reading Zohar, especially on that day. And maybe we can read with another human being the Zohar and meditate that the letters of the Zohar would help us to escape the matrix and start to experience the real reality, the reality that God wants to give us, which is the Tree of Life. Which is a reality that your heart is open and you really care for that human being and you really care for the world and you realize that you don't want to do anything with the desire to receive the self alone. You don't want to say or do or act or anything like that with what's in it for me. Only what's good for the world. Only what God wants me to do for the sake of sharing. Not my own ego. And that's the big gift that we can gain on the day of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, on the day of Lag BaOmer. And as you're helping another human being from the, to escape from the matrix, as you're helping another human being to actually start to taste the real reality, which is the tree of life, by teaching the other human being about caring for others and running away from their own ego and selfishness and desire to receive for the self alone and what's in it for me. If you can do that, you're helping another human being to escape from the matrix, and that means that you did something major in the world. You actually revealed tremendous light in the world. That's tremendous light and merit in your life. That's why on the day of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, I would like, if you have some pocket Zohars, it's a great day to give it as gift to others. If you don't have so hard, contact me, I'll send you. And it's a great day to teach other people about this wisdom, about the message of God, the message of Kabbalah, the message of the Tree of Life. It's a great day to really care for others, really care for the world. It's a great day to connect to the soul of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, which Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was such a soul, he still is, and he's continued to shine this light of caring for the entire world, caring for the correction of the world, and not stop doing whatever he can in order to bring the entire world closer and closer to the light force of the Creator. And as we're connecting to Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, we want and asking, meditating, to also start to be like it, to also start to be people that influencing the world with light, that really care for others, and really care for the world, and as a result, making a difference in the world, and as a result, bring tremendous joy to the Creator through our endless actions of love and care for others. And, you know, I'd like to read a section from the Zohar, a portion Nassau, verse 19. I'll read first the Aramaic, and we'll meditate that as we're reading the Aramaic, we're creating spiritual cleansing in our consciousness. We're escaping from the matrix and we're tasting and connecting and touching the beautiful, sweet reality of God called Tree of Life. והמשכילים יבינו מסתרה דבינה, דיו אילנה דחיי, מגינה ויתמר, והמשכילים יזהירו כזוהר הרקיע באי חיבורה דילך, דיו ספר הזוהר, מזוהרה דאמא הילאה תשובה, באלן לא צריך ניסיון, ובגין דעתידין ישראל למידה מילנה דחיה. דיו אי ספר הזוהר, יפקון במנגלות הברחמה, יתקיין בהון, אדוני בדד ינחנו, ואין אמו אל נחר. Says in the book of Daniel, around 2500 years ago, it says, the wise people will understand. It's talking about our time, really our time. And it says, those people connected to Bina, which is the Tree of Life, what does it mean to be a wise person? בשבילם נאמר, משכילים יזהירו, the wise people, it says about them, will shine like the light in the upper world. And it says, the light in the upper world, it's called Zohar. Zohar in Hebrew, it means light that is shining very strong, in a very strong way. How? Through this composition, that you wrote, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, which is the book of Zohar. So it says, basically it's a discussion between the soul of Moses and Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. And it says that Moses is telling Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, in the end of time, means in our time, the people that will be wise enough to put their study, because you can study so many things, especially today, even in the Torah, there's so much to study. But the wise people are the people that are wise enough to realize what's really important in our time, what's the most important, what can actually give me what we all want. What do we all want? We want to be happy. To be happy means life without chaos. And the wise people are the people that understand what is the wisdom that will help them to live that way of life. So the wise people study Zohar. And those people shining, there's energy shine through them like the light in the upper world. That's how we should live our life. We should shine. We should, everywhere we go, just shine positive energy. Just be happy. Just have glory coming through us. How? When you're reading Zohar, when you're learning Zohar, you're supposed to strengthen yourself with so much light that everywhere you go, you're just shining light, just shining positive energy. And it says, again, you know, when this text was written 2,000 years ago, they didn't, you know, invent the paper yet, and not the printing yet, right? But Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai already saw that in the end of time, people will have the Zohar everywhere, and people will study Zohar everywhere. That's actually what's happening now. People all around the world have Zohar and study Zohar. And it says that because people will do that, they'll be able to be connected to the tree of life. It means to escape from the matrix, the illusionary, false reality, and to connect to the real reality of God, the reality of appreciation, the reality of true happiness, the reality of desire to do good constantly, to care and to do good for the other human being and for the entire world. The desire in a pure way to connect to God without any kind of selfish desires, just in a pure way to connect to God, that's it. The desire to do good for others and for the world without any self-agenda or anything that I'll gain out of it, just that I'll have the ability to give and to share so others also will be able to enjoy and to be connected to the Creator. And when you're reading Zohar, it helps you to become that person. It's help you to let go of all the matrix that blocking you and control your mind. Slowly, slowly, you're revealing the real true nature of your soul, and you're strengthening your soul. And as a result, you become that person that we just described, and as a result, you gaining the ability to taste from the tree of life reality. And it says, this book of Zohar, it's considered to be, it's called Teshuvah. Teshuvah means in Hebrew, it's a bit hard to translate. Some people translate it as repentance. But the real meaning of Teshuvah, it means returning. You actually returning to God. And the Zohar says that as you're reading Zohar, it helps you to return to God. What does it mean to return to God? It means that every moment of your life you're thinking, just a second, is this thought, is the thought of God, or it's the thought of the matrix? It's the thought of the tree of life or the tree of knowledge, good and bad? Teshuvah means that you always returning to the source, to the Creator, and you check with God. God, help me to realize, is this thing is true, it's good for me, or it's bad for me, it's not good for me, I need to throw it away. God, I want your guidance, I need your guidance. I want to make sure that I'm not connecting myself at all to the matrix, to the truth of knowledge, good and bad. I don't want that way of life. God, I only want to be connected to you, not to anything else that is false or wrong or not good for me, or, you know, against my soul. I don't want it. God, please. Repentance is always to desire in a deep way to be connected in a truthful and deep and real way to the light force of God. And as you're reading the Zohar, it helps you to gain there that process called returning. And the Zohar says those people don't need to go through a major test in their life. Because if a person constantly check themselves, if a person constantly check, where is my consciousness? Am I selfish right now? Or is what I'm gonna say or do is really selfless? Is really, really, just really because I care for that human being? Really because I care for the world? Really because I care for God? Is that thought or that way of living life, it's the matrix? Or it's the real true of life reality? If a person constantly check themselves, then you don't need a test, an external test that comes from externally causing the person to wake up. Unfortunately, like what people sometimes go through, major catastrophes or tragics in their life or wake up call or forbid, different kind of things that people go through. It can be major, it can be not major, but still, it's shocking, it's painful. Who needs that? We don't want to learn through pain. None of us. Sometimes, unfortunately, if we don't awake ourselves to do repentance, means returning in a deep way, then, because God loves us so much, He has to wake us up so it would not be too late. But if you constantly study Zohar, that's what Rabbi Shimon Baruch Hai is saying. If you constantly are studying Zohar and Kabbalah in a truthful way, in a deep way, in a way that helps you to become a better person, not just to study it, to really grow in your caring and loving and let go, get further away from being selfish. If you're pushing yourself in that direction, then you don't need, the Zohar says, external test to wake you up. Just by learning Zohar. Because when you're learning Zohar, it awakes within the desire to correct yourself, the desire to become a better person, the desire to correct the world. That's the unique light that's available in the Zohar. And it says that because in the end of time, which is our time, the people would taste from the tree of life, which is the Zohar. So is the tree of life. Just by tasting from the Zohar, just by reading a little bit every day. Reading a little bit every day from the Zohar, tasting the Zohar, you're tasting from the tree of life. Just tasting a little bit from the tree of life, already your entire reality is being connected to the tree of life. And that helps you to get rid of the illusionary false consciousness called matrix. And it says that if people just tasting from this Zohar, just connecting, just even scanning or learning a little bit every day with the true desire to connect to the tree of life, then a person can step out from exile. Exile is not just a physical place that I'm in exile. Exile, it means that my consciousness is very far away from the consciousness of God. There's such a distance between my consciousness and God. I'm far away. Why I'm far away? Because more a person is selfish and just think about himself, then that's how you're far away from God. Not that God wants to be far away from you. You make yourself far away from God. And what's the way to step out of exile? By being like God. Means when you start to think like God, when you start to behave like God, which means caring for others, loving and caring the other human being, then you slowly, slowly step out of your exile and you become connected to the Creator. And the Zohar says that if you're just studying Zohar, just learning a little bit Zohar and studying the Zohar and connecting to the Zohar and tasting from the Zohar, You can step out of exile. You can step out of the darkness called Matrix that caused you to live in such a illusionary movie. That it's a whole big false reality. And slowly, slowly, as you're reading the Zohar and you're learning, slowly and gradually you realize another aspect of your life that you were kind of living in a illusionary reality. And another one, suddenly you start to actually realize what was wrong and what was a lie in your life and how to actually reveal what's true for you and what's real for you. And that means that you go out of exile. Usually, in order for people to go out of their own exile, it takes a lot of tremendous work. And sometimes people have to go through some kind of crisis, be also a little one or a major one, so that crisis can actually help them to open their eyes and realize, oh my God, I'm in the Matrix. I'm living such a life that it's not real. It's a whole big illusion. Sometimes only a huge shock help a person to wake up. But it says that if you're just reading the Zohar, that's it, just learning the Zohar, it helps you slowly and gradually to get rid of all the matrix, all the layers of the matrix, and you actually open your eyes and consciousness and your heart to the real reality of God. And you let go of the matrix just simply and easily in a merciful way without major kind of tremors and catastrophes. And it says about the people that would study Zohar and Kabbalah, that it says about them, God will be the one that guide them, only God, and not any other God. What does it mean? What does it mean, other gods? Other gods, it's what we just described now. It's the matrix. But the person that learns Zohar, Rabbi Shimon Bochai is explaining and promising. The person that learning Zohar, he have the ability that guide will guide him. Guide will always direct him and guide him in the right direction. Which without the Zohar, easily you can fall to the matrix and the other gods, which is, you know, the false reality, can take over your mind and mess up with your mind completely. You know, unfortunately, I'm talking with people from all, you know, areas of life, aspects of life, places in the world, and, you know, people are tremendously confused. Especially in our time, you realize that people are so confused in their consciousness. And we all need like clarity. What's good for me and what's not? What is the tree of life and what is the tree of knowledge, good and bad? We have to have tremendous clarity. And it's very hard for people to actually realize what's the right reality. Tremendous war. But Rabbi Shimon Bochai say, just use the Zohar and you'll gain the ability to realize and to see where God is guiding you every moment of your life. And the matrix, the false reality, would not be able to enter your consciousness and to take over your mind and your reality. So that's, you know, a very important section from the Zohar, what we just learned now. I want to, first of all, wish you a great week. Besides that, it's time, this week and next week, it's a great time to get ready for Lag BaOmer, the anniversary of Rabbi Shimon Bochai. So when we actually, get to that day, it's a day that we already prepared ourselves for it, so it can give us so much more and we can gain so much more and we can actually create a major shift and change in our life and help so many people in the world step out of their own matrix and start to live a real reality. A reality that is connected to the tree of life. Thank you, everyone. Much blessings to all.